Stanford University.
Within probably 2 or 3 seconds, I went, oh no, it's big and it's not stopping. The waves were enormous. The floor was moving up and down, then it started moving side to side, and I could start to hear around me glass crashing. And then my team made kind of an instant collective decision to get under the table rather than try to run down 4 floors of stairs.
Kathmandu was hit harder than many other villages or towns because it sits in a basin, in a flat area between the mountains that used to be a lake and filled up with young, unconsolidated sediments. These sediments shake at much larger amplitudes, much larger ground motions for the same incoming seismic wave than bedrock would shake in the areas around.
It's very dense. It's more dense than... This was my 5th visit to Nepal. I combined my background in earth science and partnered with people with experience in civil engineering, sociology, public health, and I developed a film intervention to motivate people to retrofit their school buildings in Kathmandu Valley, Nepal. People will take action when they know what to do, think it would work, and know someone who did it, and that last item is the most important. Over the course of the last 6 months or so, we tested that film at communities, had schools that were still in need of seismic work. So the purpose for my trip this time was to wrap up the research. And in all cases, the schools that saw the intervention video increased their knowledge of what to do, increased their belief that it could work. Yes, you can retrofit or build a new building to be earthquake resistant, and increased their intent that they would suggest to their neighbors and friends that they should build earthquake safe.
At some level, the amount of damage in Kathmandu is almost surprisingly small. Although it's a tragedy, many people expected the number of fatalities to be 10 times as large in an earthquake like this. Even as we try to help Nepal recover, we need to congratulate them on the preliminary steps that they had made in earthquake preparedness and educating the local population.
I think there is a real need for a communications intervention following the earthquake where they can see that people like them have built earthquake-safe schools and homes. In the video that I made, we visited 5 schools that had retrofitted or rebuilt their buildings to be earthquake resistant. And at all 5 schools, all of their buildings survived the earthquake. All of them. Now I can easily communicate that to thousands of other people.
For more, please visit us at stanford.edu.